Hi, thanks for tuning in for the chapter 12 wrap up. This was such a short chapter. So we're already wrapping it up and there's already going to be a short little test. So let's review. If you have your math book, then you should absolutely pull it out. Your math book will be page 76, 77, and it will have all of this information that we're going to review. So remember, this is real world problems measurement. There's length that we talked about, meters and centimeters. 1 meter equals 100 centimeters. Distances, kilometers and meters. 1 kilometer equals 1,000 meters. Mass, kilograms and grams. 1 gram equals 1,000 kilograms. I'm sorry, 1 kilogram equals 1,000 grams. And volume, liters and milliliters. 1 liter equals 1,000 milliliters. Okay, there were two types of problems that we practiced solving as well. Real world problems for both, but with one step and two step. One step is a lot simpler. It's a lot less to think about. Let's review here first. Length. So here's an example. Pole A is 134 centimeters long. Pole B is 103 centimeters long. Both poles are placed end to end. What is the total length of both poles? They added 134 plus 103 to get 237. The total length of both poles is 237 centimeters. That was an example of a length that had one step. Here's an example of a distance that has one step. The distance between Sam's house and school is 455 meters. The distance between Sam's house and the library is 280 meters. How much nearer is the library than the school to Sam's house? 455 minus 280 equals 175. The library is 175 meters nearer. All right, here's an example with mass. The mass of a block of cheese is 2 kilograms. Chef Clark buys 16 such blocks of cheese. What is the mass of cheese Chef Clark buys? 16 times 2 is 32. He buys 32 kilograms of cheese. And then here's an example of a one-step problem with volume. Chloe fills 4 identical tanks completely with 112 liters of water. What is the volume of water in each tank? 112 divided by 4 is 28. The volume of water in each tank is 28 liters. Okay, so now let's move over here to reviewing two-step problems. These are a little bit more complicated. On the test, it would be really smart if you use the bar models to help you because they are there to support you in your thinking. Let's look at these examples. Sally has a length of ribbon 2 meters long, and she cuts 6 equal pieces from the ribbon and has 110 centimeters left. Okay, so she's got these 6 pieces here. Here's the 110 centimeters that's left. What is the length of each of the 6 pieces? So 2 meters equals 200 centimeters. 200 minus 110 equals 90, and 90 divided by the 6 equals 15. So the length of each piece is 15 centimeters. See, they had to do first, they had to subtract, and then they had to divide. Here's another example over here. This is our last one before you get to some review questions. Joan buys 3 cans of oatmeal and 2 bottles of liquid detergent. The mass of each can of oatmeal is 3 kilograms. The mass of each bottle of liquid detergent is 500 grams. What is the total mass of the items? Okay, so first they multiplied 2 times 500, excuse me, equals 1,000. And then they added 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1 equals 10. So 1,000 grams equals 1 kilogram. The mass is 10 kilograms. Okay, so now that we've read through and gone over that, the review questions, the problem-solving review questions are on, in your book, on page 78. It says chapter review, test, problem-solving, solve, use bar models to help you. So there's 1 through 7, and number 7 has part A and part B. I'm pretty sure, yep, that's it. So now would be a good time to stop the video or to pause me while you go through those, because I'm going to show you the answers now so that you make sure you're on the right page, so that when you take the test, you can just do your very best. Remember, on this review, if you get a wrong answer, that's really not a big deal at all because you're reviewing. But the most important thing, because wrong answers tell us so many important things, is figure out how to solve it so that the next time you have a problem that comes up that's similar to one of these, that you remember that. Just because you get it wrong, no big deal. The important thing is do you know how to solve it now? Even if you didn't get it right the first time, do you know how to now? Awesome. That's the growth right there. So you got this. Just tell yourself you got this, even if you maybe don't feel like you do, or if you do, whichever. Tell yourself you got it, and you're going to do great. All right. Here we go. Here are the answers. Okay. Check back soon for the next math lesson.